In this block, we will see how to fetch contacts from our mobile device into our application. So you may have seen applications like WhatsApp. They fetch contacts from your device and populate them in their application. So in the same way, now we try to fetch the contacts in our mobile device. So the first thing is we need to add a recycler view here. So why? Because we are fetching the contacts and showing them in the form of a list view. So here we are adding a recycler view, and then we need to design the view. So the name and the contact number here. So these are the two text fields which I am considering in the design aspect. So it's a simple design just to show our contacts in the list view. So now first, we need to create a model class here. So the model class consists of name and phone number variables, and we are getting them from our device. So we are making use of the getters and setters here. So to fetch the contacts and to populate them. So here it is a recycler adapter here. We have declared, which is extending a recycler view.adapter, and we have provided the view holder. So here we have considered the variables layout inflator and the model class. We have considered contacts and a list here. So here we are fetching the data and we are trying to set to our views here. So before getting any further in the adapter class, now let us try to look at the main activity once. So here we have declared the variables here, and we have initialized the recycler view, and we have set the fixer size as true here. And here we have also configured with the layout manager to our recycler view, and we have initialized our contacts class. We have initialized an array list using our contacts model class here. And here when we come to the show contacts contacts function here, we are checking whether the permission is being granted or not. So in the manifest, we need to add a permission read contacts, because we are trying to read the contacts from our device. We need to seek the permission of the user before accessing their device contacts. So here we need to check whether we have the user had provided us the permission or not. Starting from Android Marshmallow, the permissions are compulsory to fetch the data from the user device. Either it might be contacts or images. We need to fetch the permission of the user. So we are checking whether we got the permission or not. And yes, if we got the permission, then we will proceed with the process, or else we will ask the user to grant the permission to proceed any further. So here, as we got the permission, we fetch the data using the content URI here. So here we are making use of an asynchronous class and fetching the user details like name and number here, and we are storing them in our contact model class. And later on, we are passing the data to our adapter class so that it will be populated onto our recycler view here. So after fetching the data from the main activity here, we are parsing the data here. You can see we are parsing the list with the fields which we are having, like name and phone number here. So this is how we get the contacts from our device and populate them onto the recycler view. So here now let us try to see the output once. So now we need to provide the permission to fetch the user contacts from the device, and here you can see the list of contacts available in our device are being populated now. So the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And if you are having any queries in the implementation, do let me know in the comment section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Android.